Drawings of Satan, demons, and bombs were displayed throughout Eric Harris's website. But on the front page of the website were the words from songs by KMFDM, words that would later chillingly strike all too close to home for those who went to Columbine. Words like shockwave, massive attack, atomic blast, son of a gun is back. Claybold and Harris fulfilled the words of KMFDM and other groups like Actors Following the Script. Other declarations on Harris's website stated, "What I don't like, I waste. I have come to shake your faith." KMFDM also has songs like Under Satan. With bombs blasting and guns firing, Claybold and Harris came to waste several of their fellow students and shake their faith at Columbine. In one KMFDM song, they state, "Our records have stickers with a warning, because they're no good for kids. KMFDM forwards the ultimate sound and a message from Satan if you turn it around." Rolling Stone magazine understood the incredible power of music to influence people and culture, declaring, quote, "A song or an album can change your life. A great concert will change it on the spot." Sadly, when it was all over, Claybold and Harris had changed the lives of 12 students and one teacher by killing them and changing the lives of several others forever. Claybold and Harris sought to conclude the nightmare at Columbine by blowing themselves to hell with their shotguns. Words also found in KMFDM's music. If I had a shotgun, I'd blow myself to hell. KMFDM, of course, was not the only destructive group that encouraged evil that Claybold and Harris were into. They were also into the German industrial band Rammstein. Two members of Rammstein were thrown into jail after being confronted with the news that two of their fans, Claybold and Harris, had murdered several people in the schoolyard. The MTV News Gallery reported that Rammstein defended their lyrics by stating that there were no, quote, lyrical content that could have possibly influenced such behavior. They declared that their music was all about love in all of its shapes and variations. You be the judge. What you are now seeing is a song called Weiss's Flesh, all about not love, but about going into the schoolyard and killing other people. Here we see actual footage of Dylan Claybold readying himself to kill in the schoolyard, just as Rammstein sings. In his song Role Model, Eminem sings the following. Follow me, do exactly what the song says. Smoke weed, take pills, drop out of school, kill people and drink. Follow me, do exactly what the song says. Smoke weed, take pills, drop out of school, kill people and drink. Spin magazine stated that Eminem wrestles with the quote ramifications he knows he has on his listeners. In his song I'm Back, he declares, quote, I take each individual degenerate's head and reach into it, just to see if he's influenced by me and if he listens to music. And if he feeds into this blank, he's an innocent victim and becomes a puppet. In the same song, Eminem goes on to declare his desire to go to Columbine and blow more children away. His record label conveniently blanked out the word Columbine to soften the wicked blow.
I take seven from stand them all in line. Add an AK-47, a revolver, a 9, a Mac-11 in an order to solve the problem of mine. And that's a whole school of bullies shot up all at one time.
Eminem said nobody ever looked at it from the effing point of view of the kids, Claypool and Harris. I've been that mad. When dealing with the question of how many young lives are being destroyed as a result of his lyrics, he plays dumb and sings,
I never knew why, knew how to affect this kid. I never knew why, giving him slit his wrist. I never knew why, giving him to hit this. I never knew why, knew how to get this big. I never knew why, knew how to affect this kid. I never knew why, giving him slit his wrist. I never knew why, giving him to hit this.
On other occasions, Eminem's true colors come out. Eminem admits that many of his rhymes are, quote, intended to push listeners' buttons.
Little kids wanna swear just like me. Run around screaming, I don't care, just bite me. I think I was put here to annoy the world and destroy your little four-year-old boy, your girl.
Students who knew Claypool and Harris claimed that they were also into the music of Marilyn Manson. Besides Satanism, drugs, homosexuality, self-mutilation, suicide, and murder, Manson's message is the destruction of Christianity. Manson said, hopefully I'll be remembered as the person who brought an end to Christianity.
My fellow Americans, we will no longer be oppressed by the fascism of Christianity. And we will no longer be oppressed by the fascism of beauty. Because I see you all sitting out there trying your hardest not to be ugly, trying your hardest not to fit in, trying your hardest to earn your way into heaven. But let me ask you, do you want to be in a place that's filled with a bunch of...
Very few people know the truth about what really happened at Columbine, as the liberal media has largely ignored the truth. Claypool and Harris were actually targeting Christians. Not only were Cassie Bernal and at least one other girl shot to death after being challenged to profess their faith, but other Christians were targeted as well. Harris and Claypool virtually became everything that Manson and the culture of death preached that they should become. Eric Harris wrote, I long to blow up and shoot everything I can. What I don't like, I waste. Feel no remorse, no sense of shame. I don't care if I live or die. In the video they made before the Columbine massacre, Claypool and Harris spoke of their hatred for Christ and Christians. What you are about to hear are actual audio recordings made before the murders. Harris said of Jesus Christ, they pre-planned asking Christians if they believed in God and then killing them for their faith. Claypool and Harris planned to make fun of bracelets, what would Jesus do, commonly worn by Christian students, and then blowing them away. Harris then makes it known what he will do to Christians, and did it.
I will shoot you in the head. I will shoot you in the head.
They shot Rachel Scott in the leg and asked, do you believe in God? She said, yes. They retorted, then go be with him now, and shot her in the head. Rachel's stepfather pointed out that they targeted his daughter specifically because of her faith in Jesus Christ.
The evidence is just very compelling to us that that they knew who she was, they knew what she stood for, they knew she stood for Jesus, and they took care of it that way.
After several people were trampled to death at one of the Who's concert, Peter Townsend of the Who said callously, quote, we're not going to let a little thing like this stop us. We're a rock and roll band. You know, we don't blank around worrying about 11 people dying. Townsend was reported to say by Time magazine, quote, rock is going to kill me somehow. It gets everybody in the end.
Look at my life. Look at my generation. How did that work? Jimi Hendrix, Brian Jones, Janis Joplin, Keith Moon, the list is f***ing endless. They're dead people. My life is full of dead people. They're dead people. My life is full of dead people. My friends are dead.
Jim Morrison, who admitted receiving his music from Satan and to being demon-possessed, also would die very young in what is believed to be a drug-related heart attack.
They're dead people. My life is full of dead people. How did that work? How did that work?
God's word declares, quote, "Do not be wicked and do not be a fool. Why should you die before your time?" Both Brian Jones, who created the Rolling Stones, and Jimi Hendrix, seen here together, not only trafficked in demonism, but both would meet an early death as well.